I will discuss about dysphagia. Dysphagia is a presenting problem in gastrointestinal disease. Dysphagia is defined as difficulty in swallowing. It may coexist with heartburn or vomiting, but should be distinguished from both global sensation and odynophagia. What is global sensation? Global sensation is this in which anxious people feel a lump in the throat without organic cause. And odynophagia is a pain during swallowing, usually from gastroesophageal reflux or candidiasis. So, dysphagia may coexist with heartburn or vomiting, but should be distinguished from both global sensation and odynophagia. Dysphagia can occur due to problems in the oropharynx or esophagus. Oropharyngeal disorders affect the initiation of swallowing at the pharynx and upper esophageal sphincter. The patient has difficulty in initiating swallowing and complains of choking, that is, mechanical obstruction of the flow of air from the environment into the lungs, nasal gurgitation or tracheal aspiration, drooling, that is, flow of saliva uncontrolled from the mouth, dysarthria, that is, speech disorder caused by muscle weakness, hoarseness, and cranial nerve or other neurological signs may be present. Oesophageal disorders cause dysphagia by obstructing the lumen by affecting motility. Oesophageal disorders cause dysphagia by obstructing the lumen or by affecting the motility. Patients with oesophageal disease complain of food sticking after swallowing, although the level at which this is felt correlates poorly with the true site of obstruction. Swallowing of liquids is normal until strictures become extreme. Dysphagia should always be investigated. Endoscopy is the investigation of choice because it allows biopsy and dilatation of suspicious strictures. If no abnormality is found, then barium swallow and video fluoroscopic swallowing assessment is indicated to detect motility disorders. In a few cases of esophageal manometry is required. As discussed earlier, dysphagia could be esophageal dysphagia or oropharyngeal dysphagia. Food sticking after swallowing and or there is regurgitation and or there is regurgitation, then it could be esophageal dysphagia. If food sticking after swallowing and there is regurgitation or there is regurgitation, then it could be esophageal dysphagia. However, if there is difficulty initiating swallow and or there is choking or aspiration, then it could be oropharyngeal dysphagia. In suspected cases of oropharyngeal dysphagia, video fluoroscopic swallowing assessment and neurological investigation needs to be done. Neurological disease that cause oropharyngeal dysphagia could be bulbar palsy, pseudobulbar palsy or myasthenia gravis. In suspected cases of esophageal dysphagia, endoscopy and biopsy are advised. If dysmotility is found, then mammometry or barium swallow is advised, which could indicate either achalasia or non-specific motility disorder. However, if oesophagitis is found, then it could be peptic, candidiasis or eosinophilic. But if stricture is found, then it could be benign or malignant. Benign could be peptic or fibrous rings, whereas malignant could be due to carcinoma of the esophagus, carcinoma of the stomach and eccentric compression.